in the sunrise, even in the nighttime. It's hard to adjust now, cause you ain't around, no. Do they treat you real nice? How'd you like a new town? Hard to adjust now, cause you ain't around, yeah.
Hey guys, welcome back to Culinary Ninja. Today we're going to be making focaccia, which is the same thing as pizza dough, just with herbs and spices and stuff like that. And it's really good, and you can use it as sandwich bread or just eat it warm or cold. For now, we're just going to proof our dough, and we're going to learn like a lot of new terms. Trust me, I don't know any of them yet either. But on how, what goes on when you're making bread, because it's the first time I've made bread. So we're going to just do proofing the dough, and that means like doing the yeast and the flour, and then we'll move on to adding the herbs. So here we go. So this step is a little complicated, but it's actually really not if you do everything right, but you just need to make sure that your yeast is okay. So if you're not sure if your yeast is really fresh, you can pour the hot water in the bowl and do what's called proofing the yeast by just pouring the yeast over it and stirring, and then keep it in there for 5 minutes just to see if it's like still alive, because if it's not active, then you can't use it. But I already knew mine was alive, so I just threw it in there. So I just took my 2 cups warm water in there, put in my yeast, and then stirred. And then after you do that, you need to add the oil. That's the 1/4 cup, not the excess. We'll get to that later. Then you only add in the 5 cups of bread flour or all-purpose and the 2 teaspoons of salt. And then you mix until basically, like, the dough, when you keep mixing, and it's really hard, but it'll work. The dough basically comes away from the bowl because it's just so easy to manipulate. After your dough comes away from the bowl, you are ready to take it out of the bowl and start working with it by rolling and kneading. So take a small amount of unbleached bread flour or all-purpose flour and put it on your surface. You can use a counter, you can use a pan, really anything you want, as long as it's flat and clean. So take your excess 1 cup of flour and put it into 1/4 cup measurements, and you'll use this as needed. So basically what you want to do is take the bowl out on the flour that's unmeasured and then just roll it out. Now you can begin kneading your dough. This is the part where you're going to be wanting to use your excess flour a lot much less than when you have to roll it out, which isn't really necessary but does make it a little easier to work with here. After I did this using the whole thing of dough, I separated it into 2 because this recipe does make 2 focaccias. And so basically what you want to do is, I've never kneaded, so this was actually really hard for me, but it was really fun because as I was doing it, I just instantly remembered when my mom made this, how she did it. So basically what you want to do is, after you, I kind of just estimated with the flour, but I did end up using my 6 cups, and right there I just splashed it all over my pants like a moron. Anyway, what you want to do is you want to take the dough and like take each little corner and push it back into the center and then push it out, and then do that with the same other one. So you're basically kind of just folding, and this makes it a lot easier. Once your dough becomes silky smooth, or not really silky, I just did it till it was smooth and pretty looking, you just want to keep making sure that the entire piece is silky smooth, and then you can move on to the next step. But make sure you try and use at least 5 3/4 flour, otherwise the flavor in your dough won't really develop as well as it could, so make sure you do that really well. now we're going to do what's called the first rise. This allows the flavor in the dough to develop and for the most mass of what your dough is now to happen. So basically what you want to do is, there isn't really a way to say for time, but this should take about an hour to do, between 40 and 60 minutes, but you might go over. I went for 70 and I feel like it could have gotten higher. So just really, if you think it can go higher, it's really just that if it measures. So take some extra oil. This is the oil that was unmeasured also. So there's lots of unmeasured oil in this recipe, but you're gonna need some for coating the focaccia when you put it in the pan. You're gonna need some for when you made the bread and now you're doing it here. So basically just take all of your dough and push it into this bowl with the oil all around and just kind of like coat the entire thing. And your hands will be really slimy, but this does help a lot. So after you do that, try to wipe off your disgusting hands like I did. And I was very rushing towards the sink. I could not stand it. Anyway, after you do that, you can cover it with a paper towel or a just towel, really, whatever you want. And leave it there for about 60 minutes so it can rise. But if you feel like it should be higher, you can wait about 15 more minutes. It really won't hurt it. This allows for the flavor in the bread to develop.
Feel it in the sunrise, even in the nighttime. It's hard to adjust though.
After your 70 minutes are up, or 60, or really however long it took you, as long as your dough rose, that's really all that matters, but try and get the most rise out of it. Now you get to do the fun part. This is punching the dough down. As you can see, forcefully hitting it, not really as hard as I can, but just punching it. And after this, you don't want to try and let it rise again because you kind of just punched all the air out of it. So just keep punching it as hard and fast as you can. Really do whatever you want. It's really fun. After you punch it down, shape it into two rounds. So this is really easy. You just take a knife and you cut the dough in half and then you just form it into two little ball things that kind of stand up on their own. And then after that's done, you can move on to greasing your pans. After you make your two rounds, you actually want to put them in a bowl to allow for the second rise to happen. And this is really easy. You just put it in the bowl and let it rest for 15 minutes. And you have to cover it. Just make sure you cover it. It's really important that that happens. So then you can start greasing. So now we're greasing and we're taking a pastry brush, or really anything that you have will work, but I just like to be professional. So take your pastry brush and some olive oil. That's the extra olive oil again. I flavored mine with some garlic and some red pepper flakes and some salt and some pepper and some rosemary and thyme after I did this. So in this step, you don't need to flavor it yet. You're just coating. So just try and get a really even coating on the sides and all over the bottom. And you can use a pizza pan or a baking sheet pan. And I'm going to use both. So I'm going to have a round one and a rectangular one. So you can really use whatever you want as long as it will fit in the pan. So make sure if you have a smaller round, put the smaller round in the pizza one, and put the bigger round in the rectangle. Another day. Another day. Once you are able to grease the baking sheets, you can roll out and stretch the dough and let it rest because it will become tough. So when you're resting, you just want to leave it alone for 5 minutes because it is a gluten product, so it will be very hard to work with. So try and get it to fit in the pan, and this might take a long time, but it's really worth it because it turns out amazing. So just try and have it fit in the pan as well as you can and make it flat, because the one that's in the circle pan that you can see did not turn out as flat as I wanted to, but that's okay because it was still delicious and I pretty much polished off the whole thing in one day. After that, after you fit it in the pan, you want to use your fingertips like I did before and kind of poke onto the bottom of the pan. Like, really you want to feel the metal on your fingertips, and this will allow air and it will make it look really pretty. Then you brush with more olive oil and you sprinkle with salt. And I added some toppings. I added some sliced onions, and if you're adding toppings, make sure that they're not thin, because mine burned and that was not very fun. So brush with olive oil, and then you can sprinkle with salt, and yeah, I already said that. And then I added rosemary, sage, minced garlic, more flavored olive oil. So I made a flavored olive oil, and then I put and that's the stuff that I coated it with, and then I added actual toppings. So I added olives, some sage, some rosemary, some thyme, and some onions. So just make sure that whatever you add, if it's like herbs, you can mince it, or garlic, you can mince it like that. But if they're onions or olives, you have to make sure that they're thick enough so that they don't burn. So you can add whatever toppings you want, just make sure that they actually cook well in an oven, because this is going into a very warm oven. It's actually going to 375 degrees. If you didn't know, I didn't tell you that. And yeah, just basically put it in the oven for 25 to 30 minutes after you're satisfied with your toppings and that it has fit the pan. The most important flavor of focaccia besides olive oil is definitely salt. And I did underdo this when I baked it, so I had to put on extra and bake it a little bit longer, but it was delicious even though the salt wasn't correctly added. So there is salt in the actual bread, but there also needs to be some on top to give it extra flavor and really bring out all those other flavors. So you want to do about 3 large pinches of salt. After that, I added more toppings and some cheese, and then I wrapped them up and then let it stand till it gets puffy. This step's also really important because it allows more flavor to get into your bread like before. So this is the third rise, technically, and then you put it in the oven.